Good evening, and welcome to the commencement ceremony honoring the 2023 graduates of Holy Trinity Diocesan High School. We would like to recognize the presence of our distinguished guests, Bishop John O. Barris, the Bishop of the Diocese of Rockville Center, Pamela Sanders, Superintendent of Schools for the Diocese of Rockville Center, and John Pierapato, Director of Administration for the Department of Education. I would also like to offer a warm word of welcome to our previous principal, Ms. Kathy Moran. At this time, I would like to invite the senior members of the select choir to take their positions. We are pleased to have with us today Father Francis Sarpong, our school chaplain. Please stand as Father Francis will offer an opening prayer and remain standing for the singing of the national anthem performed by the members of the select choir.
We pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Gracious and loving God, we ask you to bless our graduates and their families who celebrate this grand milestone. May they find comfort from our Titan community's continuous support as they journey through life. May the long line of the Titan tradition be their strength. For with it today, these graduates join a several-year-old network of Holy Trinity alumni. Bless their lives from this day on to stay true to their dreams, to discern what is good for their lives, and to use their gifts in service of others. Finally, empower them to walk into the future with faith, hope, and great love. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lady of Perpetual Help, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Please be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce the salutatorian of the class of 2023, Miss Sarah Wicks. Sarah achieved a weighted GPA of 103.85 while being a valued member of many academic and extracurricular activities, including the National Honor Society, captain of the girls' badminton team, and digital design director of the school newspaper. She will be attending Stony Brook University Honors College this fall, where she intends to major in psychology.
Good evening, Bishop Ferris, administration, faculty, family, friends, and my fellow graduates of the class of 2023. Tonight marks a major milestone in the lives of the class of 2023. After tonight, our high school days will truly be behind us, but they must not be forgotten. To my fellow classmates, I encourage you to take the best parts of these 4 years, whether they be devoted friendships or heartwarming memories, and keep them close to your hearts. Hold them tight to use as nourishment for the long journey that we are about to embark upon. From this point forward, we will all be setting out on different roads of life and following our own unique paths. We will travel to unfamiliar places, meet new people along the way, and make our own individual choices. It is important to remember that, no matter who we are or where we plan to go, no one path is superior to any other. Regardless of the lanes we have stayed in during high school, or which roads we choose to go down in the future, we are all connected through our time here at Holy Trinity, and therefore owe it to each other to have each other's backs and support each other along our respective journeys. This is when our school saying, once a Titan, always a Titan, truly comes into play. Life after tonight will certainly never be the same as high school, and there will be no more Mr. Grillo around to tell us to check our emails. It's only fair that we lend each other a helping hand and treat each other with kindness as we transition into places unknown. Within these last few weeks, I have noticed that many of us have been so enthralled by the prospect of graduating from high school and moving on to the next best thing that we have forgotten to reflect on how far we have truly come since freshman year. We have changed so much and managed to overcome the many, many bumps in the road to get here tonight. While some of us has chosen to take the scenic route through high school, others have taken the fast lane and grinded as hard as possible to achieve our goals. Nonetheless, we all have made it here together, and we deserve to take this time, step on the brakes, and acknowledge how much we have learned, experienced, and grown along our shared high school adventure. Our class had made landmark achievements in academics, athletics, theater, fine arts, and service projects that will have a profound impact on the Holy Trinity community long after we are gone. We have accomplished so much despite the challenges we have faced along the way, which proves that there truly is a light at the end of the tunnel that can be reached through hard work and perseverance. As we leave high school and enter into the world at large, we will each have our own destination that we want to arrive at in life. This may come in the form of a dream career, a technological advancement, a way to better the environment, or a fulfilling family life. No matter what, we must choose the roads that we want to go down to reach our goals. The way in which we traverse throughout life should not be determined by the judgment of others, nor what is considered normal in society. We have the right to create our own paths to happiness with the foundations of kindness, acceptance, and dedication that we have built up throughout our time at Holy Trinity. I'd like to express my genuine gratitude for the many people in my life, including my parents, close friends, teachers, and my wonderful guidance counselor, Mrs. Kilkenny, who have helped me overcome the countless bumps along my road these past few months. Senior year has been anything but easy, but it has certainly become the most memorable year of my life thus far. I hope that we are all able to look back on our high school experience with fondness, despite the many obstacles we encountered, and be confident in our ability to go out into the world and pursue our dreams with the love and the support of the Holy Trinity family on our side. As Bill Withers famously sang, "You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on." I wish you all a long and happy life. Thank you.
At this time, our select choir will perform "You'll Never Walk Alone."
Heart
I now have the distinct honor of presenting the graduates of the class of 2023. In order to ensure that the name of each student can be clearly heard by those in attendance and those watching remotely, we respectfully ask that all applause be held until the final graduate in each row has been called. We thank you for your cooperation in making sure that each family can enjoy the moment that their child has so richly earned. Bishop Barris, administration, faculty, and families, I present the members of the class of 2023 who have successfully completed the academic requirements mandated by the State of New York, the Diocese of Rockville Center, and Holy Trinity Diocesan High School. John H. Abney IV. Christopher R. Abney. Samantha P. Adiego. Sahara J. Alexander. Merrill A. Allen. Rebecca M. Almodovar. Andrew P. Amante. Ashley S. Anderson. Christopher J. Bacon. Catherine T. Barquette. Jaquez Bartholomew. Karen E. Batres. Amanda J. Beck. McKenna R. Becker. Presenting her diploma is her mother, Michelle Becker, member of Holy Trinity's Science Department. Jacoba E. Benitez. Sophia E. Beazulu. Daniel M. Blayprince. Jordan A. Blanks. Alexandra Branch. Irvin L. Briggs IV. Michaela F. Campbell. Kimberly Carbajal. Chad D. Case. Nelson Castillo. Jalen M. Chambers. Joshua J. Chensang. Colleen F. Chonaki. Paul R. Chonaki. Taylor Coker. Julian N. Crandall. Christian A. Cruz. Maya E. Colin Connors. Julia A. DeSaro. Tyler Davis. Matthew B. DeFalco. Nicholas DeVecchio. Angeline DeSeer. Dylan A. Durand. Kimberly L. Eckberg. Angelo X. Farfan. Zoe I. Fisher. Lauren Ford. Daniel E. Frooks. Kyle A. Fruccione. Catherine S. Galliano. Zola T. Garcia. Sarah Jean D. Jesse. Evan J. Glusich. Aiden Golden. Elizabeth Gonzalez Portiles. Jonathan Gregg. Elizabeth K. Gribben. Brooke M. Grossjung. Braden J. Henry. Samuel J. Horn. Brianna A. Irons. Amani N. James. Marley A. Johnson. Emma L. Johnson Schumacher. Sarah M. Johnson Schumacher. Audrey E. Jones. Jaden B. Kennedy. Andre T. Curtin. Daniel T. Kohlmeyer. Justin T. Kohlmeyer. Kyle J. Kozlowski. Sophia N. Lanice. Alexis T. LaScala. Elijah T. Lawrence. David L. LeBlanc. Andrew K. Locke, Jr. Alyssa S. Long. Dulce M. Lopez Aviles. Chongrei Ma. Sean K. Maddy. Joseph D. Marconi. London M. Marzalek. Yasmin E. Matthew. Fatima S. Maya. Brendan Badu. Samantha J. McCormick. James McCoy. Megan M. McGinnis. Declan S. McLeod. Ulia Maholchek. Zayden Michelle. Mackenzie J. Miller. Justin D. Morrow Grissom. Colleen E. Murphy. Hayden C. Murphy. Thomas H. Murphy. Hasive Z. Nagel. Caden J. Wifajacko. Jordan J. Ocampo. Mackenzie E. O'Keefe. Kira P. O'Neill. Christian Jansen G. Passis. Matthew J. Pagan. Brianna R. Pagano. Anthony M. Papa. Alan Parent. Aisha V. Patel. Alani M. Paul. Angie G. Pavone Flores. Anthony D. Paz. Nadira S. Peaks. Caitlin Pemberton. Morgan B. Peterson. Dylan J. Petricone. Francesca P. Pisano. Zachary R. File Schaub. Jenny Piquium. Jackie A. Quinn. Nicholas C. Quiros. Almari N. Red. Gabrielle D. Rodriguez. Jaden M. Russell. Karen Deep K. Samra. Cassie A. Samuda. Giovanni A. Siegel. Molly R. Scraybutt. Amir A. Smith. Bianca I. Smith. Edward B. Sotelo. Kyle J. Strayhorn. Takai T. Taylor. Aaron F. Tenner. Kara R. Theodore. Christian Toussaint. Zahir Travers. Gabriella C. Ergillis. Sebastian Velasquez. Jesse M. Ventura. Nico G. Vellante. Alexis R. Vividor. Bethany G. Valero. Daniel Warzinski. Elias M. Wayne. Aletha E. West. Jeremiah W. White. Sarah S. Wicks. Milan S. Williams. Anthony J. Willatica. Zion Woodhull Trippett. Zawan Yu. Matthew Zero Matitas. Brian Zweigbaum.
As we're waiting for our last few graduates to be photographed, I'd like to express my thanks to all of the people whose hard work helped to put this ceremony together. Many, many people behind the scenes, and of course, if I start to mention folks by name, I'm going to leave someone out, which of course I do not want to do. But suffice it to say that it takes a tremendous team effort to put this together. And on behalf of all of us in the faculty administration, I'd like to say thank you to those who helped to coordinate this event. Will the graduates of the class of 2023 please rise? Having successfully completed the requirements for graduation from Holy Trinity Diocesan High School, you have earned the right to move your tassel from the right to the left, signifying that you are now graduates. Congratulations, my friends. Will the graduates please be seated? At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the valedictorian of the class of 2023, Miss Aisha Patel. Aisha achieved a weighted grade point average of 104.08, while being a valued member of many academic and extracurricular activities, including the National Honor Society, the varsity swim team, and our track and field program. She also participated in the Science Olympiad. Aisha will be attending SUNY Binghamton this fall with an intended major of biology.
Good evening and welcome Bishop Barris, administration, faculty, family, friends, and of course the graduating class of 2023. First, I'd like to start off by thanking the teachers who have helped shape us, the parents who have raised us, and the friends who have helped us deal with those two groups of people. Genuinely though, we would not have been able to get through these past 4 years without all of you. I'd also like to take a moment to thank my own friends and family who have guided and helped me to achieve my best year. I'm grateful for each and every one of you and all of the support that you have given me. I truly would not be the person I am today without you all. Throughout high school, we have learned so much about ourselves and about each other. But if there's one thing that we've learned that truly stands out, it's that a lot can change in what feels like such a little amount of time. Whether it was moving schools, struggling, really struggling to stay awake during Zoom classes, or getting back into the rhythm of normal school life, we've persisted through it all. And just to remind you all of how rough it's been, here are a few examples. Remember our freshman year and that 2-week spring break? Or our sophomore year, when we had to wait for 50 rows to be called up for lunch before we got to eat? How about our junior year, when many of us, one way or another, recognized the true value of selecting B for Brady? Or maybe it's the fact that even as seniors, our class never won a single year of Spirit Night. Jokes aside though, we really have been through a lot, and we've persevered through one of the toughest times of our lives. I know several of us that came into high school unsure of what the next 4 years had in store for them. After learning so much and growing as individuals, it's crazy to think how we'll all go our separate ways with so many of us still unsure of our future to come. But if you take a moment to realize, we were and still are very adaptable and capable of overcoming the challenges that face us. So take each struggle and use it as an opportunity for growth. Conquer anything life throws at you and be sure to move forward confidently and diligently. As our time here at Trinity comes to an end, I'd like to leave you all with a quote by a wise man referred to as Mr. 305. This is for everybody going through tough times. Believe me, been there, done that. But every day above ground is a great day. Remember that. No matter how difficult times may have seemed, I'm glad to have been able to share my experience here with my classmates sitting in front of me. Once again, thank you everyone. I wish you all the best and congratulations, class of 2023.
Over the course of my time at Holy Trinity, I've met many wonderful people. And each one has shared a unique and special gift, talent, idea, not only with me, but with this entire community. And my friends in the class of 2023, you are no different. Each of you, in your own way, has left an indelible mark on this school community. And more importantly, you have left an incredible impact on those closest to you, your families, your friends, your teams, your clubs, your classes, your teachers, your community, and my friends, your world. Our Lord has blessed each of you in so many wonderfully exciting ways. You all have the ability to do tremendous things in whatever your next chapter may happen to be. And on behalf of all of us here on this stage, I get to be the one to say how proud I am and how proud we are of all of you. So job well done, my friends. Congratulations. At this time, it is my distinct honor and pleasure to introduce the Superintendent of Schools for the Diocese of Rockville Center, Ms. Pamela Sanders.
Thank you so much, Mr. Grillo, for sharing your time with me tonight. I am so blessed to be able to stand up here as your superintendent, to see all of your wonderful accomplishments. We are all so very proud of you. But I have a very important question to ask you tonight. The question is, how did you get here? How is it possible that you are graduating from Holy Trinity High School with friends to your left, friends to your right, about to move on to this next important phase of your life? Allow me to share a story with you that may help you frame your answer to this question. The story is about a man named Charles Plum. Plum was a U.S. Navy jet pilot during the Vietnam conflict. After 75 combat missions, his plane was blown out of the sky by a surface-to-air missile. Plum ejected. He parachuted into enemy hands. He was captured and spent 6 years in a prisoner of war camp. Luckily, he survived the ordeal. Now turn the clock forward many years. Plum and his wife find themselves sitting in a neighborhood restaurant. A man at a nearby table approached and said, "Hey, you're Charles Plum. You flew jet fighters in Vietnam from the aircraft carrier Kitty Hawk. You were shot down." Taken aback, Plum asked the stranger, "How in the world did you know that?" The man replied, "I was on the Kitty Hawk too. I'm the guy who packed your parachute." Plum sat there stunned, unable to say another word, as the man shook his hand and said, "Hey, I guess it worked." Plum finally replied, "It sure did. If it hadn't, I wouldn't be here today." That night, Plum couldn't sleep. He couldn't stop thinking about the man from the restaurant. Plum recounts, "I kept wondering what he might have looked like in a Navy uniform. I wondered how many times I might have seen him and not said good morning, or how are you, or what's up? Because you see, back then, I was a cocky, self-absorbed, hotshot Navy fighter pilot, and he was just a sailor." That night, Plum thought about this man and about how many hours the sailor had spent standing at a long wooden table deep in the bowels of the ship, carefully weaving and folding the silks of each chute so that they would work perfectly if ever needed. This random encounter at a neighborhood restaurant changed Plum's life forever. He now travels around the country as a motivational speaker. After telling his story, he concludes his presentation by asking his audience one unforgettable question: who has packed your parachute? It's this question that I ask of the class of 2023 this evening. Who is it that packed your parachute so that you would land softly on your feet to be here tonight in this school, about to move on to college and careers with a life of possibility ahead of you? Did you do it on your own? Did you really get here without any help? Do you literally have wings to fly and to land on your own? Or did you, like Charles Plum, have someone behind the scenes covering your back, packing your chute so that you would have this night? St. Ignatius of Loyola claimed that the world's greatest sin is the lack of gratitude. Let that not be true for Holy Trinity's class of 2023. Graduates, I ask that for 1 minute you stand. Turn around. Look at your parents, your friends, your families. Who packed your parachute? They're right there behind you. Turn around, face your teachers. Who packed your parachute? Please be seated. Be grateful for the education your parents and your families provided for you. Say thank you. Be grateful for the education instilled in you by your teachers. Say thank you. Be grateful for the church that supports you. Say thank you. And most of all, be grateful to a God who loves you unconditionally and will be by your side forever. God has poured out his blessings on each and every one of you. Use these gifts and talents he has given you fully. And say thank you by your actions. I pray that God grant each of you here in attendance tonight, and you, the class of 2023, a grateful heart. Congratulations. At this time, I would like to introduce our esteemed Bishop, John Barris, who will share with you some final remarks and lead us in a closing prayer.
Dear parents, grandparents, families of the class of 2023, Pope Francis once said that marriages and families transform the world and history with Christ's love and the mission of mercy of the Catholic Church. Dear parents, what an incredible evening for you. All the sacrifices, all the living of the Paschal mystery, all the trust in divine providence, the daily shepherding of your children in Jesus Christ. I just want to thank you and congratulate you. God bless you. Class of 2023, my short remarks will be in the context of our Catholic liturgical calendar. In the next few weeks, we'll celebrate the solemnity of Pentecost, the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity, the solemnity of the body and blood of Christ, and the solemnity of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. This weekend, we celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit, the solemnity of the Pentecost. Class of 2023, allow the Holy Spirit, say these three words every day. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. That is a very powerful prayer. Remember the tongues of flame that will purify your lives and drive you on mission. Remember the driving wind of the Holy Spirit in the Acts of the Apostles that will guide you through your educational path, your career path, your vocational path, and ultimately will guide you to eternal life with God in heaven. Secondly, we look forward to the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity, our beautiful belief in the truth that the love between the Father and the Son is poured out upon us in the Holy Spirit. And class of 2023, it's so important tonight that you embrace Father, Son, and Holy Spirit dwelling within you. They dwell within you. That is truth. That is reality. And when you allow that indwelling of the Trinity and that incredible power to flow through you to the world, nothing can stop you. Nothing can stop you. Class of 2023, we're looking forward to the solemnity of the Most Holy Body and Blood of Jesus Christ. J.R.R. Tolkien, many of you have seen or read The Lord of the Rings. He was a passionate Catholic. And he once said at the end of his life, I put before you the one great thing to love on this earth, the body and blood of Jesus Christ. There you will find true romance, true honor, true glory, and the true way of all your loves upon earth. Confirmandi, think about that. When we're anchored in the Eucharistic heart of Jesus, all our human loves, our future marriages, the future university roommates that you'll meet in just a few months, the friendships that you'll make, when they're grounded in that fidelity to the Sunday Mass and a Eucharistic philosophy and spirituality of life, the Eucharist is the true way of all our loves upon earth. So, class of 2023, I just want to ask you to consider making a decision tonight that as you cross the bridge from Holy Trinity High School to whatever university or work you'll be doing, have a radical fidelity to the Sunday Mass. Have a radical fidelity to the body and blood of Christ. And in the body and blood of Christ, in the rhythm of the Mass being the rhythm of your life, you'll discern so beautifully where the Holy Spirit will take you in your education, your career, your friendships, your vocation, and ultimately all the major investments that you make in the kingdom of God on earth. And the final solemnity, class of 2023, is the most sacred heart of Jesus. And on this, the day of your graduation, don't hold anything back in your heart from Jesus Christ. Give your heart entirely to the most sacred heart of Jesus. You've studied human biology. You know that when you sit still, you can actually hear your heartbeat. Allow the rhythm of your heartbeat to reflect the rhythm of the heartbeat of the most sacred heart of Jesus. What is that rhythm? It's the rhythm of, learn of me, for I am meek and humble of heart. It's the rhythm of the Paschal mystery, the death of Jesus on the cross and his powerful and beautiful resurrection that transforms our life. It's the rhythm of the seven sacraments, and it's the rhythm of mercy and heroic and courageous forgiveness that we experience in the sacrament of penance and that we share with the world. Class of 2023, we are so very, very proud of you. And once again, allow your heart, give your heart, don't hold anything back from our Lord. Give your heart, on this the night of your graduation, give your heart entirely to Jesus Christ. Let your heart beat with his heart. Please stand. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we ask your blessings upon the class of 2023, their dear families, and all those here at Holy Trinity who have supported their road to holiness, their road to really enriched living. We ask that the Holy Spirit may lead you and guide you with the Holy Spirit's tongues of flame and driving wind. We ask that the power of the Holy Trinity dwelling within you and within your soul may express itself creatively to the world. We ask that your devotion to the body and blood of Christ may be the true way of all your loves upon earth. And we ask that the Holy Spirit may enable your hearts to beat in unison and in rhythm with the most sacred heart of Jesus. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you all.
Christmas.